Hey, it's Fran, again, with a redo of the original vent hood that I did for my new M3 printer. Just remember, it kind of came out and made the flat cover that I made for that vent hood sort of unusable. So I really had to go back to the drawing board and come up with a new idea, and I decided to make an extended box type acrylic cover. And I started by taking a little piece of cardboard and taking a tracing of the actual plywood part of the vent hood that I had already made and making this template that is going to be exactly to scale to the actual vent hood that I can make this new acrylic box cover from directly. I'm going to be making this entirely out of 3/16 inch acrylic sheet. And once again, back at the factory, oh, there's Dot. Dot likes to hang out in Scott's part, and Scott's going to help me here because he is the king of the table saw. And so with Dot looking over everything that we do, which she loves to do, she likes to hang out.
Tyrannosaurus Dot.
I went over with Scott about exactly how we would go and do this. I had some ideas and got the template actual size that we're going to use as a reference to compare all of the cut parts to. This is another thing that I wanted to make sure that we got a really good fit because I know that tolerances are going to be very critical. So Scott borrowed a really appropriate acrylic cutting blade from the organ shop. So we ended up using that in the saw. So I thought, well, this will probably just take about 20 minutes and I'll just get Scott to help me out and we'll do this and cut these pieces and yada yada. But honestly, even with a really top of the line table saw, perfect equipment, Scott's expertise and everything, and even with the both of us double and triple checking the geometry and the measurements of everything, this process of just cutting the parts, it took the better part of an hour just doing this. And even though I've edited this down and sped it up and everything, this was about an hour of work to make sure that everything was on spot. Cutting out the template and actually taking it and holding it up to the acrylic pieces, making sure that everything is exact, because this really had to be accurate to a fraction of a millimeter, because the entire acrylic box had to be exactly the right size in all proportions and had to be square. So what I did here is the two critical pieces are going to be these insert parts that are going to be going on the insides of the box on two sides that all of the other sides are sort of attached to. So what I did is we cut one piece of acrylic with that diagonal from the template, and then I took sticky tape and stuck the two halves together on the using the hypotenuse as the alignment, and decided that from that we would just cut down both pieces simultaneously because they're stuck together with sticky tape. And so in this way, once we got it squared and everything, we cut out the pair of sides, and this would ensure that both of the sides are exactly the same size, shape, and angle, and that would be the core of making this box completely square and straight. So it looks like it's going to work out. And again, this took a long time, especially making sure that we kept everything square, not making any mistakes, and I really didn't want to do this twice. So there we go. So the two halves stuck together, and cutting the remaining pieces, and like I said, about an hour later it was all cut out and done, and here's the end result. A pile of acrylic pieces, all precision cut and with the templates. And now I had to go through a process of actually assembling. First thing I had to do was to separate those two side pieces that were stuck taped together. And again, this was kind of critical to make sure these two parts were exactly the same size and shape. And also I had to make some marks. These two pieces are going to have to go together to form the two pieces at the top. And I'm also marking which sides I'm going to polish up and which are not, because when I actually go and join these parts together, the parts of the box that get joined, those edges have to be rough. It's when you do this kind of gluing, I think the rule of thumb is to not polish down the sides that you're actually gluing together. But I used some fine sandpaper on a block. I like these foam blocks for doing acrylic work because they do sort of conform, and it really does a good job taking out all of the tooling marks out of the plastic. And once you get all the saw marks out, you can run it through a nice buffer, running the speed down. It's really tricky with acrylic. You gotta have, I guess a lot of patience with it. But I had to run the buffer really slow, because if you run the buffer too high or use too much compound, you just liquefy the acrylic and it takes away from the idea of having, straight edges and a really good fit. But I polished up all the exterior corners, and again, lining up these two pieces are going to make the top, and I'm going to be putting a hinge between them, so I wanted to make sure that these two were going to mate together very well. I'm laying out the hinges, and I'm doing a little different than I did with the other one. I decided to put the seam in the middle, so I'm lining up to mark these hinges to cut just the ends off. And once I've got them marked, it's easy just to line them up and set them on the table of the block and just cut the pair of them. And again, this super toxic glue, it works really wonders with acrylic, but the fumes, I mean, it's really toxic. It's got some really nasty solvents. So a full chemical respirator is used. And again, these acrylic hinges, just like in the last one, they have like a special plateau in them just for gluing, and a recess around the hinges themselves, which help to protect the hinges from the glue. And I'm laying some blocks on it just to keep some weight and keep them as flat as possible while they're drying. And do the other one, being careful to line it up. And again, a couple of blocks just to put a little weight, just to make sure that cures. And after the glue is set, I'm gonna take the pins out, which are also acrylic. And I got to separate this to do the final assembly. And I'm also going to be making this so that the hinges are removable, so I can take the cover off if I need to. So just an easy separation. This isn't quite like dry, but the glue sets up to handle in about 5 to 10 minutes. You can move it around a little bit. And it takes about 24 hours to fully set. I'm going to set those aside and get to doing the gluing of the main part. This is actually the face, and I'm just pulling the paper off of the inside of the face. And that's the bottom piece. Again, just taking the paper off the inside. And I'm going to be using squaring blocks to keep everything at a 90 degree angle to the table. And I'm using these blocks with sticky tape to help me to position the pieces. And I've cut the paper away from the very bottom of these pieces. Again, I'm trying to protect as much of the outside of the acrylic as I can from the process of actually making this, but I took the paper away from the very bottom where I'm going to be gluing to prevent, gluing the paper into the seam. And I did this just by peeling away the edge and then just using a pair of scissors just to skim over and, cut off the paper, leaving the rest on just as some protection against glue and, other stuff. Again, this is the far side inset, and I'm taking the paper off the inside of that. One of the things I had to do with all these pieces is make sure that they're straight, because there is some, this stuff does bend, and just from storing, it wasn't quite straight, and this needs to be really a complete 90-degree box, and everything had to be straightened. So I had to double-check and do some adjustments as necessary before actually going and trying to glue these pieces. Again, using another squaring block on the far side that's going to be used to actually hold that piece in a register, and that's going to help in the gluing process. And I'm just getting a feel to make sure that all these parts are going to come together before I even glue it, to make sure the measurements are right, and it turns out that it is bang on. It's perfect. We did everything right. The tolerance is right. So, this is going to be perfectly square. So time is not really a friend when you're working with this glue. It starts to set pretty fast, and so I had to have everything planned out. Again, full chemical respirator for the fumes, and then I'm working as quickly as I can to glue up all the joints and interiors, Again, this really helped having these squaring blocks set up, because I could just pop it in place. I didn't have to really fuss too much, and just basically had to check the corners, make sure that the corners are all level and flush. And because I've already straightened out the pieces and everything, the middles just sort of sort themselves. And the squaring blocks are helping me to align the middle and put it, where it should be. And it's doing pretty good. And I use blocks to hold the ends on and everything. Yep, that's the whole thing right there, all glued together, and had to sit overnight with the blocks, and it looked pretty good even before. And then the next day, take all the blocks away, and, removing the squaring blocks with the sticky tape. Again, a little chisel action. Chisels are so handy for getting into the tight recesses where you got to separate things. I use them all the time for the sticky tape and for parting parts off of printing beds and everything. But taking off the protective film, and again, another block and sticky tape. Chisel again, just get it in there. With the chisel action, you just use the bevel of the chisel to put it flat against the interior, and then you just get the sharp edge of the chisel in the slight crack, and just a little wiggle, and it pops it right out. So you don't actually use the sharp end against anything. And there you go. It's looking pretty good. I had some flash and some overspill, because, I'm just not that good at this. So there were some areas here, like, where I had to trim away blobs of glue that had sort of flowed out and sort of stuck to the table a bit. So there was a little bit of cleaning. And I got a little bit of glue on the interior when I was doing that last piece. It sort of, there was like a hair of glue that stuck on the interior. And man, I'll tell you, this glue, it's so aggressive. Once it makes contact with the acrylic, it just bites in, and there's really nothing you can do about it. So it looks like there's just, it's not perfect, but yeah, I think you really need to have like a special gun to use that glue. So what I'm doing is I'm marking centers for some screws I'm going to be putting, and I got to drill out the holes, and I came up with this handy little trick, because the big problem with drilling acrylic is it'll get bound up in the drill and pull up the acrylic off the work surface and, snap and go sideways. So I put this aluminum plate clamp down just to hold the acrylic down while I drill through the top through a recess in that little block, and it's really worked great for keeping everything exactly where it had to be and drilling a nice clean hole. So I don't know why I didn't think of this earlier, but it's really a good trick to drilling an acrylic. You just use a sacrificial surface and a block to hold it down, and just using a countersink again, because I'm using countersunk screws, and countersinking the holes. And that's pretty much it. All the machining and work is done at the factory, and screws fit, so looks like I'm done, and this is ready to install. So here we go. I'm putting it all in place, and now I've gone and added some thin layers of foam to the plywood parts, again, just to help with the sealing. And two parts of the hinges, I've put little nuts on the ends so I can get them in and out, again for removing the face if I need to. So I thought that was a nice upgrade too. So I don't know exactly how, much I'm going to have to open this up or take it off, but makes it easy for future stuff. Add a couple of bump-ins in the corners, and these act as little rests, because the hinge does add some thickness to it, so when I open up the case and put it over the top, the little bump-ins, they sit like little feet, and it's a nice rest, so that really completes the whole thing. I have to say, I really like how this is turning out. I'm just making some marks for the screws that are going to hold the weight of the new lid. Drill out some holes. Get all of the little bits off. I like to keep it clean. And I'm putting these ones in the front in by hand, because the torque is pretty critical. I don't want to warp or crack the plastic. Now, I did put a seal on the wooden part of the vent hood, but in order to really make it complete, I had to put a little seal in the hinge, because these plastic hinges, they have a lot of play, and even though I kind of put them together like really, really tightly, with the weight of the front and everything, it does open up more than a millimeter or so. So I put a thin, thin layer of this thin foam to make a perfectly good little seal. And with trimming that off, it really is just like right on, because that fills up the gap from the hinge. And now it is a perfectly sealed vent hood all around. And yeah, this is much better than the other one. And the final peel, waiting for the last, for the final peel of the face tape. And I really hate taking this stuff off acrylic, it's just, but with a little work, patience, it is done. It's all done. Looks very space age, it's like something from the Thunderbirds. I'm very happy with how this turned out. It looks good, and it's exactly right, and it's a perfect seal. So now that the vent hood's together, it's time for me to go in there and reattach the filament and reload the filament in the machine and to run a test print. Looks pretty good. The torture test print that comes with the OctoPrint. I let it cool for about 15 minutes. And I found to get models off of the build plate, a sharp chisel, if you just kind of leverage it, just use the sharp edge just to kind of grab the very edge of the print, and it's just enough, if you're very gentle with it, to just kind of pop the print right off the print bed. Right off, I think that it's a pretty good print. Taking up a close look, and I'm really impressed with the ability for this to print the overhangs without any supports, because you can see it's got these various overhangs and recesses, and also this little comb kind of print, again testing the resolution there. Some tweaking, I'm sure I could get this better, but just right out of the box, those overhangs and those compartments, they were without any support material. And again, this is the benefit of having those fans cooling the filament as soon as it's printing. So I'm very impressed with the general resolution. Again, without doing any kinds of adjustments or refinements. Looks pretty good. I'm pretty happy with that. So there you go. We're ready to rock. New vent hood, Mark II. Looks good. Works perfectly. A good seal. Very space age. Looks like it should be on Tracy Island. Maybe Brains could borrow my printer now. All right. Thanks to everyone on Patreon for making this and all my projects possible. I'm Fran. I'll be back real soon.